WLSC is broadcasting from the Lake Forest Women's Club, where Joan Hansen will do a reading entitled The Meeting by Elsie West.
Gwendolyn, darling, do you see Fred anywhere? He must be here. It's 4 o'clock and he's always punctual to the instant. That's why I hurried you away from the furniture sale. You didn't need any new furniture anyway. You have too much in your house now. Oh, he must be here. Look around and find him, can't you? Oh, yes, of course. I always forget you have never met him. I am so fond of both of you. It just seems as if you had to know him. I'm so nervous. Do you suppose he'll find me changed? He wanted me to come to the train, but I couldn't. I just couldn't. Fancy kissing him in front of all those guards. Oh, it's different here. Girls come here to be kissed. Look at that couple over there behind the palm. They are holding hands, and you can tell from the way he grins at that blonde, he has a wife and children in Omaha. Why, certainly I hate to have Fred on the road. I'm in a terror every time he writes. But his letters are marvelous, simply marvelous. You would never guess from what he says that I have grown stouter since he married me. My dear, tell me the truth. I know I can trust you. Would anyone notice my extra 25 pounds if they didn't know I had them? Really? Then I earn chocolate with plenty of reprieve. Yes, please, waiter, chocolate and pound cake with marmalade. What are you going to have, Gwendolyn? Just tea? Oh, my dear, I'm paying. Please order what you want. Well, if you insist on tea, I'll have to take it too. Fred makes Fred furious when I indulge in my appetite. He's so aesthetic himself. Did I tell you he paints? Oh, yes, he painted a picture of our cat. He got the fur sort of greenish instead of gray. But she is such a beautiful cat, no one cares. 2 teas, waiter, and when my husband comes, you may bring an extra cup. Certainly Fred loathes tea, but he man doesn't. But since we came east, I am trying to get him into the habit of drinking it to appear intelligent. Oh, my dear, that wasn't he who went past with that girl in fables, was it? Over there. Look, they're just leaving. I should think you would recognize him instantly by the description I've given you. Why, he's so different. Would you send a bellboy through the corridor to page him? Since I wrote we would be here, he would surely come directly, wouldn't he? Suppose my letter didn't reach him. Gwendolyn, listen. This boy has a telegram for someone. Gwendolyn, how careless of you. I'm starving. I'm just starving. If you can leave on tea, I can't. I rushed off with hardly any lunch. I was so anxious to get here on time. But now Fred hasn't come. There must have been a smash up on his train. Yes, that's it. I'm sure of it now. Why didn't I think of that before? Waiter, where can one buy a paper in this hotel? Get me one, please, right away. My husband was on the train that was wrecked this afternoon. And waiter, bring me some toasted English muffins. They're so comforting. I must eat. I must keep my courage up. But I can't swallow a mouthful. Poor Fred. I'll have to wire his mother. Oh, Gwendolyn, I'm so thankful you came with me this afternoon. I couldn't have borne it alone. Why, there's Fred now.
Their entertaining monologue. We switch you back to our studios.